What's up, guys? We're heading out to do some rattlesnake hunting this morning. Me and my buddy Drew are going to hike up the mountain to one of his spots. He's had some luck in the past. Just some old power line type turf. Just some old power lines with some big rocks around them, and it seems to be where we find the snakes a lot. It's a little brushy, some laurel on the edges of it, so lots of food for the snakes. But it's the second day here in Pennsylvania for venomous snake season. You can keep one rattlesnake and one copperhead per year. We'll get into some details about the rattlesnakes and how you sex them and all that stuff here shortly. They have to be 42 inches and male, so hopefully we find some today. We can explain that a little better, but we're gonna get up here up the mountain and start poking around the rocks and see what we can find. It's about 66 degrees here this morning, so they should be out on the rocks where we can see them and hopefully find a couple. All right, we're getting down here into some pretty rocky stuff. As you can see back here, this is where we're looking. I don't know how, if you can tell how steep that is, but take my word for it, it's pretty dang steep. We are just gonna walk down along the edge of this, and there's a spot down here we've found snakes in the past, and it's crazy, they show up under the same rock about every year. So we're gonna try that spot first and then make our way down across this and see what we can come up with. All right, we're about 20 yards or so from the basking spot that we've found them in the past, and Drew pulled up the binos and looks like there's what, 5 or 6 down there, yeah, at least that we can see. They are right on that rock out in front of us, about 20 yards or so. So we're gonna ease down in there and just be careful. One thing you want to be sure of when you're sneaking in on them is you got to pay attention to everything in between. A lot of times you'll be paying attention to one in the distance and you'll end up stepping over top of one, or it's happened plenty of times. But yeah, we got snake boots on and we're gonna ease in here and see what we can see. GoPro on there. Alright, so what we're doing here is we're gonna count the subcaudal scales here, basically from the butthole back to the rattle. And that's gonna tell you, I believe, 95%.
Yeah, it's a high enough percentage that the Fish Commission, they accept it
as a male. Yeah.
That's, well, it's a female. She 19.
So we gotta count those scales that you can see there, and they, if they have 20 or more,
20 or less, it's a female.
Yep.
21 or more.
21 or more is 95% a male. So that's what you have to determine to harvest one. But these are all smaller, and this particular one that we're handling here has not been shed yet. So we're gonna.
And you can see about here back under the rock, they're coming back out. They're not too excited. If you move easy and don't get real crazy with them.
Where'd that other one go that was, that you put up here?
It went back down.
Okay. See, Drew's holding this snake and she's not really even rattling, so they're usually pretty content. And we got one down there below them.
I know, that's a black face. It's hard to tell by the color of the body. You almost have to look at their head.
Yeah, so what's the
light,
the color of their eyes determines the color phase. So blue eyes?
The Fish Commission will tell you light head or dark head.
Okay.
I always look at their eyes. They either have yellow eyes or black eyes.
So yellow eyes means
yellow phase.
Yellow phase. I just spotted a what we think might be a pretty decent sized snake right below this big rock. So Drew's kind of sneaking in on it. There, it just rattled. We're gonna sit back and see what we get here. Sounds like there's a couple down there.
There's two together. That's why they look so big.
Oh. Oh yeah. It's two together. It's what we were seeing. Made it look like a real big one down in there. There's a pretty one.
Yellow. That looks yellow, but it has black eyes, so it's actually a black face.
Okay. Well, Drew's just learning how to use his new snake tool there. Yeah, you want to be really careful when you're handling these snakes, whether you get tongs like he has or like these kind here. You can do a lot of damage to the snakes if you aren't careful. So for the longest time, Drew's just used a hook like he's got there, and as you can see, they're pretty easy to handle with that. Yeah, let's try to get a length on one. Let me put this camera down. So in Pennsylvania, they got to be 42 inches to keep.
This one's probably 38.
We're not going to keep this one, obviously, but it's roughly 38 inches.
Maybe we can get a quick.
See if we can't get the scales on this one. Can you move? I'll come down to where you're at, or you can come up to here. So you can see there that we got.
Let me get him out of the head just a hair, but there we go.
All right, so we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. 15, 16, 17, 18, 19.
19 is a female.
So that would be a female, not legal to harvest. We're going to...
Too short.
Too short and...
In the wrong sex.
Yep. So we're going to...
Put her right back here.
Put her right back where we got her. And we'll pull this little guy in here out. Let me get camera running. Okay. Let's see if we can't get this one out of here. You don't want to get these guys by the head. You want to try to get them back in the middle of the body if possible. And you don't,
just
again, don't want to squeeze.
The head and the halfway point.
So I'm using tongs, but I'm not actually squeezing them.
Right.
Oh, that is a very pretty one there. Sun's hitting them, and
that's beauty.
That's what we want out of a big one, though.
Right. Oh, timber rattlers all have black tails.
Yep.
And this is a black phase because he has a black head, regardless of what the body looks like.
Gotcha. All right, so as you can hear, we still got some snakes around us, and we're gonna sneak back up out of here and go to another spot. But you know, the main thing with these things is, you know, get your snake boots or gaiters of some sort of protection, and just do your research and get educated. You know, find somebody that's hunted snakes before and go over the safety thing. That's the biggest thing. You know, you want to be on the alert all the time. They're definitely definitely dangerous, but they're not near as aggressive as everybody thinks. And a lot of times they just, you know, rattle to let you know where they're at, and they just want to stay away from people. So what did we find, 12, 13 today or something like that? And I can't say any of them were at all aggressive. They all just kind of wanted to get away. We tubed a couple and identified the sex on a few of them, and they were all too small to harvest, and pretty cool animals to check out. And not a lot of people have probably been in places like this, so we're gonna go try to find a couple more, and maybe we'll have some more here at the end.